the virus impacting our health, the economy, and a federal gun law loophole.
We've been having historical numbers here at the CBI.
Susan Medina is a spokesperson for the CBI. Her team has been working nonstop to sort through a backlog of 9,000 background check requests from gun dealers across the state. What usually takes 8 minutes to turn around is currently taking 4 business days.
Say they don't know what's going to happen. They want to protect their families. They want to protect their lives.
Warren Marshall owns G&G Guns in Lakewood. He told us over the phone that COVID-19 has people flocking to gun stores. He says the last time sales peaked like this was just before the last presidential election.
AR-15s were the ones that were getting out the door. Now with shotguns, and I don't know why.
Along with the demand, CBI officials say social distancing is changing the Bureau's workflow.
Obviously, we're in a very different time. This isn't a situation where we can throw staff members in a room and they can knock this down.
Under federal law, if CBI cannot approve or deny a sale in 3 business days, a dealer is legally allowed to sell a gun to a person who may be considered unfit to own a gun.
Strongly encourage our FFLs across the state to hold those weapons until the background checks are completed.
The Bureau says at least one shop has already exercised the loophole and sold a gun to a person who should not have one. Agents are now working to recover that weapon. Overall, though, the state says dealers are cooperating.
We've had very positive feedback from our licensed firearms dealers and saying that, yes, they are going to hold those firearms until the background checks are complete.
G&G Guns is one of the shops playing it safe, honoring CBI's request.
People understand. CBI is doing a wonderful job of making sure people are correctly being cleared or not. They're staying after hours and before hours. You're doing this 7 days a week.
In Denver, Michael Konopasek, Fox 31. Now-